today's topic is chi-square test. The chi-square statistics is commonly used for testing relationship between categorical variables. The null hypothesis of the chi-square test is that no relationship exists on the categorical variables in the populations. They are independent. Chi-square is always non-negative. Now, how do you do a chi-square test? Calculate the chi-square statistics by using the formula. Chi-square is equal to summation Oij minus Eij ka whole square divided by Eij, where chi-square is equal to chi-square value, Oij is equal to observed frequency, and Eij is equal to expected frequency. It is common to write chi-square equal to summation O minus E ka whole square divided by E. Now, how to find the expected frequency? The expected frequency can be obtained by using the formula Eij is equal to Ri into Cj divided by n, where Ri equal to row total, Cj equal to column total, n equal to grand total. It is common to write E equal to Rt into Ct divided by n, where Rt equal to row total, Ct equal to column total, and n is the grand total. So let's start with the question. Question is, 200 students at college level are graded according to the IQ and their economic condition. Use chi-square test to find out whether there is an association between economic condition and the level of the IQ. Over here, you can see that first column is economic condition, second column is the high IQ, third column is low IQ, and last column is total. So coming to the first one, which is the rich. So under the category of the high IQ, there are the 40 students. Under the category of the low IQ, there are 40 students, and total is 80. So coming to the poor, under the category of the high IQ, there are 35 students, low IQ, 85 students, and total is 120. Second column total is high IQ total is 75, low IQ total is 125, and total is 200. So 40 plus 40 equal to 80, 35 plus 85 is 120, 40 plus 35 is 75, 40 plus 85 is 125, 75 plus 125 is 200, 80 plus 120 equal to 200. So our grand total is 200. Now coming to the solution of this equation, so let us take the hypothesis that there is no association between economic condition and the level of the IQ. So our null hypothesis is there is no association between economic condition and the level of IQ. And the alternative hypothesis will be H1. There is association between economic condition and the level of IQ. So let's take the given data as per the question. So as per the question, the data is first column is economic condition, rich, poor, total. Second column is high IQ, third column is low IQ, and last column is total. So this is for the first column economic condition, rich, poor, total. Second column is high IQ, third column is low IQ, and last column is total. For rich, under the category of high IQ, it is a 40. So it is a 40. Under the category of low IQ is 40, so it is 40, and total is 40 plus 40 is 80. Now under poor, under the category of the high IQ, there are the 35 students, so over here 35 students. Under the category of the low IQ, 85 students, so total is 35 plus 85 is 120. 40 plus 35 equal to 75, 40 plus 85 equal to 125, and 80 plus 120 equal to 200. There is a given data as per the question. Now coming to the formula to calculate the chi-square. So formula is chi square equal to summation O minus E whole square divided by E. And here first we have to calculate the value of expected value. And expected value can be calculated by RT into CT divided by N. In this question, N equal to 200, which is the grand total. Now coming to the calculations for the expected value. First find the expected value of the 40. So expected value of 40 is equal to row total, which is 80, column total 75 divided by 200. RT into CT divided by N, which is 80 into 75 divided by 200, which is 6000 upon 200, which is equal to 30. So here answer is 30. Now coming to expected frequency of 35. Expected frequency of 35 is RT into CT divided by N. Row total is 120, column total is 75 divided by grand total. So it is 120 into 75 divided by 200, which is equal to 45. Now expected frequency of 40, row total 80 divided by column total 125 into grand total 200. So expected frequency of 40, RT into CT divided by N, which is 80 into 125 divided by 200, which is equal to 50. Now expected frequency of 85. So row total is 120, column total is 125, and grand total is 200. Expected frequency of 85 equal to RT into CT divided by N, which is equal to 120 into 125 divided by 200, which is equal to 75. Now make expected frequency table. Take original table. First column is economic conditions, second column is high IQ, third column is low IQ, and fourth column is total. Now coming to the first category, which is rich. Second category is poor and third is total. Now first value is expected value of 40 is 30. So answer is 30. Second, expected value of 35 is 45. So answer is 45. Third one, expected value of 40 is 50. So answer is 50. Fourth one, expected value of 85, answer is 75. Answer is 75. Total is 30 plus 50 is 80. 45 plus 75 is 120. 30 plus 45 is 75. 50 plus 75 is 125. 80 plus 120 is 200. Now coming to the calculation of a chi-square. For this question, by using this table, we will calculate the value of a chi-square. So here, we will take the observed value, and observed value is 40, 35, 40 and 85. So write observed value, which is 40, 35, 40, 85. Now, respective expected value. Expected value for 40 is 30. So 30, expected value of 35 is 45, so 45, expected value for 40 is 50, so it's 50, and expected value of 85 is 75, so it's 75. Now coming to the third column, which is O minus E, which is observed frequency minus expected frequency. So first, 40 minus 30 is 10, 35 minus 45 is minus 10, 40 minus 50 is minus 10, 85 minus 75 is 10. Next column is O minus E whole square. It means 10 square 100 minus 10 square 100, again minus 10 square 100, 10 square which is equal to 100. Last column is O minus E whole square divided by E, which means this column divided by this. So 100 divided by 30, which is 3.33, 100 divided by 45, which is 2.22, 100 divided by 50, which is equal to 2, and 100 divided by 75, which is 1.33. So as per the formula, chi square equal to summation O minus E square divided by E, which is equal to 3.33 plus 2.22 plus 2 plus 1.33, which is equal to 8.88. So total is 8.88. So chi square value is 8.88. Now coming to the tabulated value of chi square. So for determination of a tabulated chi square value, first we have to determine the degrees of freedom. For a chi square test, degrees of freedom equal to C minus 1, R minus 1, where C equal to number of columns and R equal to number of rows. So here you can see that in a question, two columns and two rows are, so it will be degrees of freedom equal to 2 minus 1, 2 minus 1, which is 1 into 1, which is equal to 1. So degrees of freedom is equal to 1. Significance, you can see that the value is 3.841 for 1 degree of freedom, and 0.05 the value is 3.841. So chi square 0.05 equal to 3.841. If level of significance is not given in any questions, in that case by default we will take 5% level of significance. So here you can see that the calculated chi square value is greater than the tabulated chi square value. Chi square calculate value is 8.88 and chi square table value is 3.841. So chi square 8.88 is greater than 3.841. So we can conclude that our null hypothesis is rejected and it is a fail, and we can conclude that there is association between economic conditions and the level of IQ. So final answer is there is association between economic condition and the level of IQ. Why? Because we reject H naught, we reject our null hypothesis, and therefore the conclusion is there is association between economic condition and the level of IQ.